Good morning, good morning. How's everyone doing this morning? Everyone good?
Good.
Yeah, awesome. Cool. Can you do me a favor, moms and dads, while we're getting set up? Let's make sure we have the kid's name in the screen. So you can right click on the video screen and then click on rename. And then you can put your child's name, and it'd be good to have first and last name. That'd be helpful. Get working on that. Great to see you all this morning. Awesome.
Are you
going to
sit with me?
No.
Excellent. A few others of you who just rolled in, you can rename yourselves in Zoom, and it'd be good to have your child's first and last name. So you can right click on the screen and click on rename. That will help me just make sure I get names to faces. That'd be great. Awesome. People are rolling in. We're in the right spot. Fantastic. Great. Welcome, welcome, welcome. So good to have you all here. I am going to share my screen and pull up an outline that I have. But it's very good to have you all here this morning. We'll see if we have anyone else rolling in the last minute or two. Just an FYI, I am recording this morning. There are a couple people who couldn't make it and asked if we could record the session. So it is recording. So if you have any concerns about that, just be aware of that. Anything you can say will be used against you in court of law or no. Great to have you all with us this morning. I think we'll get started. It's a little after 10 o'clock. And welcome. That I'm just so glad that we can get together. It's kind of a little bit different that we do it via Zoom, but at least we can connect. And I'm going to have you kids do a lot of stuff with your moms and dads, doing some talking through some stuff, working on some stuff, and learning about Holy Communion. And some of you may have already been receiving communion. Let's just do a quick hands up just so I can see. How many of you are already receiving communion? You can put your hand up nice and high. Some of you are, and lots of you aren't, and that's okay. At Emmanuel, we welcome everybody, kids even younger than first grade. So it is great to have you here. If it's your first time in preparation for communion, or if you've been communing for a while, we will give you an update and do some teaching and help you learn more about this awesome gift that God has given to us. So welcome, everybody. Great to have you here. All right, we're going to jump into it and get you thinking about some special meals. So I want you to talk to your moms and dads about, when do you have some special meals? And what are they? And what special foods do you eat? Maybe at Thanksgiving, Christmas, family reunions, on your birthday. Because we're learning about a special meal. But first, have a conversation with your moms and dads about these questions. When do you have special meals? And what special foods do you eat? Have a conversation with your moms and dads. Go. One of my favorite special meals is when we have a lamb roast. And that's probably not something that many of you would have, or maybe not at all. But I grew up in New Zealand and Australia, and that's one of my favorite meals. And it's a special meal when my wife, Kim, cooks up a nice lamb roast with roasted vegetables. How many of you love lamb roast? Oh, yay! All right. The head. Oh, yes. We got a New Zealander, married to a New Zealander, the Stringers. So, yeah, definitely. Lamb roast, fantastic. Katie and Hadley over there. But, yeah, all kinds of different foods where that might be for birthday parties. You might have special cakes. You might have, like, really like spaghetti or who knows what, where you have turkey for Thanksgiving. We all have those special, special meals. Another question for you now. How do you get ready for these meals? How do you get ready for those special meals? How is the table set up? Do you use any special dishes, any special tablecloths, napkins, candles? What are those special meals? How do you prepare for them? So talk about that. Go. So for lots of those special meals, we make a special setup, don't we? Maybe some special candles, napkins, maybe a special centerpiece that we would put on the table, things that we would make it look special and nice for a very special meal. So we're going to learn about a special meal that Jesus gives to us, right? So you've got a handout, and hopefully you've all got that. And I'd just like a quick show of hands. How many of you families received this mailing? Because I heard that at least one family didn't. Did anyone? Okay. Oh, Beckett didn't get it either. I did send you a PDF this morning, so you do have that. Oh, good. Awesome. So I'm going to give you just a couple minutes to work on that with your kids. And what I'm going to do, I think, just for a little bit, is I'm going to put you into breakout groups while you work on this. So I'm going to give you a couple minutes, but you can just visit and chat with one another. And shoot, I'm not seeing my breakout group option. So I'm not going to send you to breakout groups right now unless I can change the setting. So I'm just going to have you start working on this handout right now and have some discussion with your mums and dads as you work on that first page. Just working on the first page, looking at Jesus who gives us special meals. So, and it says, when was the last time you had a special meal with someone you love? Draw or write in the frames to create a scrapbook page remembering that special meal. So just work on that front page right now. Going to give you a couple minutes. Go.
Was the one?
I know. I meant the day you were here. Or is it playing?
Can I give you just another minute or two? Would anyone like to hold up their picture that they're working on up to the camera and tell us about what you're working on? You can raise your hand using the reactions option and let me know if you would like to. You could hold it up. I see the Kips holding theirs up. Cool. Nice. Okay, Beckett, would you like to put your microphone on and tell us about yours?
So, my birthday, we kind of put a BB-8 up.
Uh-huh.
And then some Star Wars decorations.
Star Wars decorations, awesome. That's good to have for special meals. Yeah, thank you. Anyone else like to share what they've done? Anyone else like to? Noah's going to. Okay, awesome, Noah.
I had fondue for Thanksgiving.
Ah, Thanksgiving, yeah.
With chocolate marshmallows, chocolate brownies, chocolate pancakes, and chocolate strawberries.
This seems to be a theme there. Chocolate with chocolate with a little more chocolate. I think you might like chocolate. Is that right, Noah? Yeah, awesome. Excellent. Anyone else like to share? One more person. Anyone? All right. Maddie and August from the Erdmans. We got the twins.
It's here.
I put a cake and some balloons and a brownie.
Awesome. For a birthday celebration, cake, balloons, and a brownie. Thank you so much, Maddie, for sharing that. Appreciate that. Awesome. Good job. Special meals with special foods, right? Now, I'm going to show you a little video. And it's kind of a funny video, about 5 minutes long. And at the end, there are going to be some questions for you to talk about with your mom and dad. Now, it's called Tomatoes for Jesus, which seems kind of silly. So it's kind of funny and it's good for kids. But you know what? The one thing I just need you to know, I always say tomatoes for Jesus. You might say tomatoes for Jesus. Some say tomatoes. I say tomatoes. We're going to watch this short video, and then I'm going to have some questions for you to talk about it. Just going to get it queued up here. Just a second. Get my technology organized. Hopefully you can see that, and we'll start it up.
Jacob, are you ready for the... Whoa! What is that?
This, Julie, is a genetically enhanced hydroponic hypergrowth tomato.
Oh! What's it for?
Oh, it's for Jesus.
You're growing a gigantic tomato for Jesus?
Yes. Is that so strange?
Yeah, a little.
Well, I've just found out that I was invited to Jesus' table for a special dinner.
You mean communion?
Yeah, something like that. Anyway, I wanted to bring something extra special.
Well, that's pretty special.
Exactly. What could be more special than a 700-pound tomato? Did you know that this tomato can provide enough ketchup for over 100,000 hot dogs?
That's a lot of ketchup!
I've been working all night on this baby. It's my masterpiece. I can't wait for Jesus to see it.
You know, you don't need to bring anything special.
But I really want to impress Jesus.
You don't need to impress Jesus. He just wants you to come to his table.
All right, so maybe I don't have to bring the tomato. Still, don't you think he'd like me even more if I brought a giant tomato?
Jacob, Jesus loves us all the same. Everyone is welcome at his table.
Everyone sounds like a lot of people. You sure there's gonna be enough food?
God will provide everything.
Maybe I should bring the tomato just in case.
We don't need it.
No?
Nope.
How about a 50-pound carrot?
Don't need it.
A 10-pound pea pod?
The only thing you need to bring to God's table is you. Jesus has already prepared the table for us. Just like when your mom and dad prepared dinner for the family. All you have to do is come to the table.
So a meal with Jesus is just like a meal with my family?
Just like that.
So how is a meal with Jesus special?
All meals are special. What do you and your family do before every meal?
We wash our hands.
And after that?
Then Mom tells me to stop teasing my sister. And then I say she started it. And then she says, no, I didn't. And then I say, yes, you did. And then she says, if you don't stop, I'm going to throw food
and
at
after
you.
After that? And
We pray.
Pray to who?
God.
Exactly. You thank him for the food, right?
Right. We thank him for the food.
Because food is...
a gift from God.
That's what makes mealtime so special. It's a time when families can come together and remember that God feeds us. And a meal at Jesus' table is just like that. Only we don't just remember that God feeds us, we also receive the gift of forgiveness.
Forgiveness? Forgiveness for what?
For teasing your sister, amongst other things.
Oh, right.
You just receive God's forgiveness.
Receive?
Yes, receive. Here, like this. Receive. Receive.
Receive.
Receive.
Receive.
Receive.
No. Receive.
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 Receive. Receive.
Receive.
Receive.
Receive. That's great. You've got it.
Receive. Receive. Receive.
Well, you keep working on it, and I'll see you later at communion.
Receive. 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 Receive.
So, tomatoes for Jesus. That's kind of a little bit silly, but I've got some questions for you that I'm going to put on the screen real quick for you to talk about with your mums and dads. So, here are the questions. Things like, why was Jacob making a gigantic tomato for Jesus? Who did Julie say is welcome at Jesus' table? What did Julie say Jacob should bring to communion? According to Julie, who provides everything we need? And then why do you think Jacob had such a hard time learning how to receive? I'm going to give you some time to have those conversations, parents and kids together. Go. Let's see you all practice putting out your hands to receive Holy Communion. Receive. Receive. I think it's kind of funny. He, poor old guy, he had a hard time getting that down and doing that, didn't he? To open his hands up wide to receive. And God gives us himself. God gives us Jesus in this meal. When I put my hands out to receive Holy Communion, I usually put my hands one on top of the other, making the shape of a cross. Can you do that with me? So putting your hands one on top of the other to make a cross. And it reminds me that Jesus died on the cross for me. And then he died on the cross for you. And that we open up our hearts and our lives and ourselves to receive Jesus in Holy Communion. Yeah. We receive this awesome gift of God's love coming to us in Holy Communion. Good job. We receive. Okay, we've got another video now. And this one, you've seen Cindy. You know Cindy, our children's ministry, children's family ministry person. And every Sunday, she's got a Spark Story Bible for us, story that's in worship. And right now, we're going to watch this story as she reads from the Spark Story Bible about the Last Supper. And listen in closely as she reads, because after it, I'm going to have you do a little bit of pretending with your mums and dads as you share the story. All right, everyone can see the video now, I hope, on your screen. And it's just a short one, 2.5 minutes. Here we go.
Today, I'm reading the story of the Last Supper from the Spark Story Bible. Jesus knew that the time had come for him to leave this world. He wanted to share his last Passover meal together with his 12 closest friends, the disciples. Jesus loved his friends and wanted to show them his love in a very caring way. As the friends got ready for the meal, Jesus put water in a large bowl and knelt down on the floor. He wanted to wash the feet of the disciples. When it was Peter's turn, Peter said to Jesus, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus replied, "Peter, you don't understand what I'm doing now, but you will later." Peter loved Jesus so much that he said, "Then don't just wash my feet, but my head and my hands also." Peter wanted to be as close to Jesus as possible. As they were eating, Jesus sadly told the disciples, "Soon, one of you will betray me. One of you will tell people who don't like me where I am so they can take me away." This upset the disciples, and each one said, "It's not me you're talking about, is it?" When Judas said this, Jesus gently replied, "Yes, Judas, you will betray me." Then Jesus picked up a loaf of bread. He blessed it and gave some to each of his friends, saying, "Take this bread and eat it. This is my body." Then Jesus picked up a cup of wine. He gave thanks and said, "Drink this. It is my blood, which I must give up so the sins of people may be forgiven." When the meal was over, Jesus and his friends went to a place called the Mount of Olives. Jesus said sadly, "Soon you will all leave me." Peter felt bad. "Even if all the others leave you, I won't," he said. Jesus looked at his dear friend and said quietly, "Before the sun rises, you will pretend you don't know me three times." Peter said, "Jesus, I love you too much to ever do that to you." And all of the other disciples said the same thing.
Awesome. So thanks for Cindy for sharing that story with us today. And now I've got a couple things for you to act out at home as you remember the story, because this is about the special meal that Jesus gave to us called the Last Supper. All right. So what I would like you to do, first of all, parents, pretend that you are washing your children's feet, because that's what happened at the beginning of that meal. And as you do that, talk about how King Jesus was on his hands and knees washing the disciples' stinky feet. Wow, Jesus came to serve his disciples and serve us. How do you think you might feel if Jesus was washing your feet? So parents, pretend to wash your kids' feet and talk about how Jesus got down on his hands and knees at the table and washed the disciples' stinky, stinky feet. Go. Jesus really became a servant at the table, because that would have been the job of one of the servants to clean the stinky feet of the disciples. But Jesus, King Jesus, gets down on his hands and knees and scrubs the dirty toes of all of the disciples. Wow, what a servant Jesus is. That's amazing that he would do that. All right, now pretend that you're sitting at the Last Supper with Jesus. And this is, moms and dads, if you've got some bread or some juice available, that would be great. And pretend that you're sitting at the table with Jesus. And then Jesus says these words, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me," as he hands them the bread, right? And then with the cup, you can say, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins." All right, oops, I'm going to put that back on the screen. I'm just going to give you a couple minutes to pretend that you are sitting at the meal with Jesus and use these words as you then eat and drink. Go. And this is how the meal started. This is how Holy Communion started. The disciples were eating a special meal called the Passover meal with Jesus. And Jesus changed the Passover meal celebration quite a bit. I think the disciples were really confused when Jesus changed the words. When he said, "Take and eat, this is my body," I think the disciples looked at one another and like, "What? Did he just say, this is my body as he holds up a piece of bread? I think Jesus got it wrong." I think the disciples were really confused because Jesus changes this meal up from just remembering the Passover, something that happened a long time ago in the land of Egypt, to something that was very different. Now Jesus says, "Here I am in this bread. Here I am in this wine, in this cup." Wow. Jesus changes up this meal. These are the words that we have written in our Bible, and these are the words of Jesus. And there's a fancy word at the top of your screen, the words of institution, which means the words when communion began, how it really first began in the night in which Jesus was betrayed. So this is the night before Jesus goes to the cross and he dies, when he has this special meal. He says, "Our Lord Jesus took bread, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, 'Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me.'" And then later, after supper, he took a cup and he gave thanks, gave it to them all to drink, and saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you, poured out for you for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of Jesus." So this is where the meal began. Now I'm going to have you take a look at the next two pages in the handout in the center section. And there's some things that I want you to work on and look at there. So you can see what it says down the bottom. You've got some things to look for. You're kind of comparing what it's like for Jesus to be sitting at the table with his disciples and what it's like for us to be sitting at the communion table. And there are lots of similarities that you'll see there. So take a look and look at those. So Jesus gave us a special meal for the forgiveness of sin. We call that meal Holy Communion. Another name, the Lord's Supper, or another name, the Eucharist. That's a funny name, but we don't often use that word at Emmanuel, but sometimes. So then what you need to do, this is what it may have looked like when Jesus and his disciples ate the Passover meal together. Can you find these objects in the picture? So you can see some bread, grapes, some hands, cup, cross. So look for those in the picture. And then thinking about what it looks like in your church, in our church at Emmanuel. So then you can draw the bread and the wine and the way that it looks like on our altar. You probably haven't seen that for a little bit, but I'm going to give you a couple minutes to work on that with your mums and dads. Go. So Jesus gives us this special meal, Holy Communion, or the Lord's Supper, or the Eucharist. He gives it with bread and wine, and he gives us himself, his body and his blood comes to us in this meal, which is really amazing. It's really a mystery how that works. It's just really amazing. But we trust that's what God says, that he shows up, that Jesus is in this meal, and that we then have Jesus in us. Just want to tell you a little bit about some of the different bread and wine that you may see us use at communion sometimes. Now, it's very different in these pandemic times. So, and we have very few people in church at a Sunday, but if you would come to church during the pandemic, we don't want to share any germs. So we will have a little tiny container like this. And in this, there is a little bit of wine. And in the top section, actually, I've got one open here. There is a little tiny wafer that's tucked right in there. And you can take it out. And you've got some little bit of juice and a wafer. I like to call these Jesus Lunchables. It's kind of a funny name, pretend name, but it's Jesus in a little container of bread and wine. So that's one way we can receive Holy Communion. When you come and receive communion with our pastors coming up here in a couple weeks, you will receive a wafer, a little piece of bread, and then you'll have some wine or some juice in a little tiny plastic cup. So that's another way that you can receive Jesus in bread and in wine or juice, okay? And sometimes, I think I've got this on the screen, when you come, you open your hands wide to receive Jesus, right? Open your hands wide to receive. And it's really good to look up at the pastor or look up at the person who is serving you Holy Communion, because they're going to look right into your eyes and saying, this is the body of Jesus given for you, the blood of Christ shed for you. They're going to look right at you, so you look right at them. Sometimes you'll be kneeling at the altar rail, and we'll be doing that when you receive your communion and coming up in a couple weeks' time. Again, there'll be a wafer and then a little cup of juice or a cup of wine. And if you haven't tried the wine, I encourage you to try it. I think what I'd like to do when you come on that day for communion, that we'll have a little testing station set up so that you can taste the wine, taste the wafers before you come and commune, so you know what to expect. So we're going to work on that. When we don't have a pandemic, another way that we receive Holy Communion is by dipping. So then we have a big cup and we have our wafer and we dip it into the wine or into the juice. And the fancy word for that is intinction, fancy word for dipping right in there. And sometimes, again, when we don't have a pandemic, we have some real bread rather than these little kind of styrofoam pieces. This is actually bread, but it tastes kind of funny and dry. And we also, if someone has an allergy to gluten, we have these special little wafers, which are called gluten-free wafers. And your mums and dads will let you know if your tummy can't handle a regular wafer, that you might want to have one of those. So there are different ways that we receive bread and wine. After we have received both the bread and the wine, we can say amen. So I want you to practice that with your mums and dads a little bit, because amen means yes, it shall be so. So the pastor will say the body of Christ given for you, and you can say amen. The blood of Christ shed for you, and you would say, amen. I want you to just practice that. Moms and dads with kids. Moms and dads, pretend that you are serving communion to your kids and have them practice saying, amen. Again, amen means yes, it shall be so. This is the body of Jesus. Yes, it shall be so. This is the blood of Jesus. Yes, it shall be so. Jesus coming to us. You've got another handout there on the last page, and I want you to work on write that now. You can unscramble the words on that page. And I know you'll be able to figure those out. So I'm going to give you just a couple minutes to do that. Jesus said, this is my... Figure that out. Unscramble the letters, unscramble the words. I'll give you just a minute more to work on that. If we don't quite get finished up right now, you can finish it later. But I'll give you about a minute more to work on that. While you guys are working on that, I want to show you, especially mums and dads, that we have got some stoles that have been made by a lady in our church, Becky Farniak. So we thank Becky for making these stoles. And thank you to our great kid models. We've got Madeline and August showing what these stoles look like. They are really beautiful. And on them, you can see that there is a grain of wheat. And that's where we get bread from, is from wheat, right? And some grapes, and that's where the juice or the wine comes from. So we're going to have these available for your kids to wear when they receive communion, and you can take some photos with them. Right now we have 8 of them, so we were initially planning to have one for everybody, but just to loan and just to use on the day of Holy Communion. We aren't giving these for you to take home, but just to use as a special thing to wear when you receive communion as a first grader. So know that they are going to be available, and we give thanks to Becky for that. But if you feel uncomfortable with your kids wearing them, knowing that some other kids might have worn them previously, just be aware of that, and you can just let us know how you feel about that as it gets a little bit closer. So we're inviting you to sign up for communion with your household. And just so you know how this is going to work, we're going to have 2 time slots, one on that Sunday, February 7th, and then on Wednesday afternoon of the 10th between 4 and 5 o'clock. There are going to be 2 household time slots for each of those 15-minute increments. We're going to have 1 pastor in the sanctuary and 1 of our pastors in the fellowship hall. We've been using our fellowship hall for household and individual communion on Wednesdays. So it looks nice, kind of looks like a little chapel that we have. So we invite you to sign up for a time slot that you can come and receive communion with your first grader. And again, I'm hoping that we can set up a little taste test just immediately before, so your kids aren't surprised by the taste of the wine and the wafers when they receive communion. In your packet of materials that you received in the mail, you will also have a take-home pack that you can refresh and focus in on and relearn some of the things that we talked today. So you've got a take-home pack. There's also this God Cares For Us handout in your packet as well. In our curriculum, we are only doing 3 weeks of learning, and this God Cares For Us is for a fourth week. So it's a bonus, it's an extra. And you can choose to do that with your child at any time if you'd like to, or if you don't get around to it, that's okay. But I wanted you to know that that is a bonus handout in our curriculum for in as we share and we learn. All right, that brings us to the end of our first session in learning about Holy Communion. Thank you so much for gathering with us today. I hope you have a chance to get out and enjoy the snow this afternoon, the fresh snow, or maybe help Mom and Dad clean the driveway or the sidewalk. But thank you for joining us today. And we'll see you next Sunday. And let me know of any questions. Let me know if you do not, a couple of you who didn't receive the mailing, give it a couple of days, and maybe let me know on Wednesday if you don't get it, and then I will PDF you the handouts for next Sunday. All right. Otherwise, see ya. Thanks for coming, and we'll see you next Sunday.